5 stages of grief. Denial. I rush to your room, a small iced tea from Dunkin' in my hand, lemon, 2 sugars. I see your face and the world is still, the screams in my head, the only thing I could hear. She's gone, and whispered sorries from nurses that don't even look at us. The social worker should be here soon. She died 5 minutes ago. We're still filling out the paperwork. You lie in that bed in a room overlooking the water, and it almost feels like a vacation, though your face shows no color. You lie there, and my tears are falling like each of my eyes a broken faucet, filling the sink of this can't be happening until we reach the point of this is not happening. This can't be happening. I go home, and the air around me is imperfectly still, completing the scene I created in my head. You're coming home soon. I'm going to see you again. Repeat, repeat. I search for your voice every time my phone rings. I won't eat pickles except on cheeseburgers because I'm waiting for you to share them with. I walk into your house and I can almost see you sitting, asking me what I want for dinner and why I haven't done anything with those papers on the table. Almost. Anger. Why did you leave me? You didn't have to leave me, not yet. It wasn't supposed to happen yet. You didn't even tell me just another day. I needed just 5 more minutes and I could have seen you. Am I not important to you? Do I not matter? How can you leave me here like this? Bargaining. Maybe I could have given you another day. Maybe if I missed that concert the night before, maybe if I stayed with you all night and didn't let go of your hand, maybe you would still be here. Maybe I could have helped your lungs to keep breathing, your heart to keep beating. I should have been there to save you. I'm sorry. Depression. I know this is my fault, but I don't know how to live like this. I don't want to live like this. My heart is empty and there's no one to fill this space. I don't want anyone to fill this space. It's not theirs, it's not even mine. It's yours. I see you in everything, and how can I get out of bed knowing that you won't be there to catch me when I start crumbling? I am crumbling, I can't stop crumbling. I don't even want to live anymore. Acceptance. 1 year later, and my heart still feels empty sometimes. Maybe most of the time, but other times I know I have enough of you to fill the empty spaces to the ceilings with photo albums and home videos and everything I learned from the greatest teacher out there, but nothing involving math homework, because that was never your specialty. I don't know where you are or what you're doing, and I can spend years trying to figure out if there is a heaven, but right now I'm trying to fill that emptiness in my chest with everything you would be proud of.